You guys started this with that conversation we had earlier about the offense exploding. So we wanted to make sure we held up our end of the bargain. But it was just an incredible performance by the guys in that locker room. You know, sharing the basketball, touching the paint, kick out for threes, rebounding the ball. And I continue to say it goes back to our defense. When we can get stops, when we can rebound, and we play in the open floor, it's some of our best basketball. It's a really fun game to be a part of.
And you guys got 2 days of practice there. Like, was there anything you guys tried to work on adjustment-wise that you felt like you put into that game and you saw it out there or anything like that?
Play harder. That's number one. We have to play harder and consistently no matter who we play against. We know we're more than capable. Defensively, play together, communicate, finish possessions, and offensively, share the basketball. Continue to play with confidence and share the basketball. Tonight was a good step in the right direction.
You talked about the three-point shooting during practice on Monday, but it seems like, you know, shooting is contagious. You got like 26 threes. CJ has 9 of them. How much did his individual explosion lead to the entire team giving it up?
Yeah, CJ ignited the whole group. He got us going early. He did the same thing last time we played here. He got going early, shooting the basketball with confidence. Guys started to look for him, and it's like you said, it's contagious. Now other guys are getting a part of it, and you know, it's once again, it's beautiful basketball to be a part of, and it's fun to watch.
And since the start of training camp, you talked about the importance of increasing the volume of three-pointers, one of those teams. And you guys have experienced some ups and downs with that, but just seeing how consistently it's been going up and up throughout the course of the season, how gratifying has that been?
It's extremely gratifying to see the team buy into what we're trying to accomplish. We go over it over and over again on film. We get on the floor, we work on it. And it's great for them to come on the floor, have some practice days, and then have that carry over in the game where we continue to trust that these shots are open for us, we're gonna take them. I thought CJ, Brandon, Z, they do a great job of finding their teammates. Z with 11 assists tonight, career high for him. So that's what it's about for us, continuing to get stops and make sure all the guys are involved.
Yeah, I was gonna ask about Z next, because you talked at practice yesterday about getting the ball in his hands early, career high in assists. How much did that kind of play into that, him just getting involved early, getting the feel for it, and kind of being able to put his imprint on the game?
You know, as we continue to learn our team, put the ball in his hands for the first few minutes of the game is important, because now you have B.I. and you have C.J., you got Herb, who shoot the ball well too. All of those guys are spaced. It allows Z to attack the basket, touch the paint, and if they help, he's going to make the right play 99% of the time, and that's what he did tonight.
One of the things we saw for you guys was going to Larry there to start the second half.
We're continuing to evaluate our first unit, and we want to try to, as best we can, continue to help that group be the best that they can in the minutes that they play. And that's a way that we can shorten the minutes and see how Larry looks with that group. You know, JV will continue to start, but, you know, sometimes we're miss kind of matching the groups up to get the best groups on the floor together. Trust, that's what it comes down to. All of us, our players, everybody on the staff, the coaches, like everybody, just continue to trust in each other. And you have to do it even more when you play against the best teams like Phoenix. When I say Phoenix, that was our last game. Continue to trust each other. Continue to trust that if you make the right plays on both ends of the floor, the guy next to you is more than capable, and the energy, the ball finds energy. So I'm proud of our group. We all are. We're proud of this group, you know, having the response that they had after last game, and we want to continue to build on it.
They could have cut it to 6. Herb makes the block.
Yeah.
What about that sequence?
I mean, I think that changed the game for us in the second half. Herb, like you said, he makes the block on Collins. We go down and score. I think they take the ball out. He gets the steal, dunk, timeout. Now it's a 12-point game or 10-point game, something like that. It changed the game for us. It changed the momentum. And, you know, you don't want the game to come down to those plays because we were playing well, they got back in it, but Herb Jones made two incredible plays that really changed the momentum of the game.
There's something, I guess, like more specific of a catalyst, or like was there like more urgency stressed on getting this number of attempts up? That's a lot of attempts, and you guys are generating more than you pretty much ever have. You're breaking franchise records.
Yeah. It's definitely, we're making a conscious effort to score when we have opportunities to. And the way the league is that we want a balanced offense. And we know we can get to the paint. We know we can get to the free throw line. We have to do better at shooting threes. It's what we came out of last season with, excuse me. But it's a credit to our guys. They're buying into it. We're showing it. And they see the results. And that's the biggest thing is when you get results early, when they see the difference and when we shoot threes and when we make them, you know, it's hard for teams to stay in games with us. It's difficult. It's difficult to balance the floor when you have guys spaced, especially with the driving capabilities of Zion, of Brandon. You can throw the ball to GV in the post. CJ he's a three-level scorer. Herb, you got guys that can all drive the ball, but they can all shoot. It's difficult to match up.
Well, it seemed like you had Utah on their heels all night, and you noticed Larry Nance came in the first quarter. It seemed like every rebound he grabbed, he's trying to push the pace. Really? And then right after that, when Zion re-entered the game, he was really pushing the pace, too, after that. Is that really the identity of the team? Not only getting stops, but then just getting up the court as fast as you guys can.
It was our emphasis coming out of the last loss. We watched film on it, and we got on the floor and worked. And that's the deal is when we get stops, we let's get up and down the floor and let's play fast, let's play together. And tonight was a great example of that.
Does it look like Zion to you maybe has more energy when he's going up and down the court like this in this type of game, has the ball more in his hands?
He does. It's something that, like I said, we're learning more and more with our group and how to keep defenses off balance. And especially with the starting group, putting the ball in his hands early helps us. And so we'll continue to look at it, but we like what we saw tonight.
Coach, you talked about bouncing back. You did it after the Nuggets game, also after the Clippers game, and now tonight after the Phoenix game. How do you like how your team's responding to tough losses with big explosive games right after?
We enjoy it. We enjoy taking on the challenge of, you know, we didn't play our best game, and let's come back and be better. And it's a credit, once again, to the character in the locker room. I'll say it again. I'm extremely blessed to have an opportunity to coach this team. Griff and his staff, they've done an amazing job of bringing in high character guys, and they make our jobs easy, but that's what you see. When these guys go and respond, they care about each other, they care about the game.
And when you say some spectacular dunks from Zion, but what were your impressions?
That was crazy. The one-hand dunk was that was pretty spectacular, but, you know, he can do things like that, and I don't get used to it, for sure. I do not. Every time I see it, I'm amazed.
I know you got multiple all-star level players, but you know, I think CJ is now perhaps the highest scoring average guy for a guy who hasn't made an all-star game. Just what do you think about his candidacy for a guy, for what he's done this season and just, you know, what he's been able to accomplish in his career?
Yeah, I mean, he's the consummate pro. He's done it all his career, and we would definitely love to see CJ get an opportunity to be an all-star. But I think he'll agree with this. More importantly, you know, we want to have a deep run into the postseason and playoffs and have an opportunity to do some damage in May and June, hopefully. And so we want those things to happen for all of our guys. But more importantly, we want them to continue to do everything that it takes to contribute to winning, which they're doing.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thank you.